Jai Shri Krishna, Jai Shri Ramachandra, Jai Shri Lakshmi Narasimha. So dear viewers, this video is all cut bhaiya. Jai Shri Narasimha, Jai Shri Krishna, Jai Shri Ramachandra. Bhaiya cut sahi. Jai Shri Narasimha, Jai Shri Ramachandra, Jai Shri Krishna. So today dear viewers, this video is all about respiration. So respiration is a vital process for our lives, and it is necessary for the process of breathing and breathing out, breathing in and breathing out. So this breathing in and breathing out is called as respiration. So there are two types of respiration. That is the normal respiration of breathing in and breathing out, breathing respiration. And the second one is going to be cellular respiration. Cellular respiration is nothing but the energy getting formed with the glucose and many other chemicals. So cellular respiration, we can keep it as a side topic for today, because this cellular respiration is all about making energy and not about air. So to continue with, so the breathing respiration to begin with is going to be with the help of at least a few organs. That is one lung, the right lung and the left lung. The right lung has three parts: the right superior, right middle, and the right inferior. And the left lung is smaller than the right lung, so it has only two parts: superior left and inferior left. So here we can see the two lungs. And bhaiya, can you please come forward? And here's the diagram, which is so funny and just a small funny sketch. And here are the two lungs, and from here the trachea is coming. Trachea is a windpipe. So starting from the nasal cavity, the air is breathed in, and this air is taken in whether through the nose or the mouth. So there are two cavities through which the air can get in. Can you go a little backward? Yeah, so the air can get in through two cavities: the nose, the mouth. So the larynx and pharynx help for this work, and the larynx is generally called the voice box. So this helps in creating, producing voice, because when the air passes through the larynx, there are two voice glands over there, and they help in producing voice with the help of air. And then there is a pharynx above the larynx, from here to here. So in the pharynx, the food as well as air is passed through, and this is like a small, you know, door to the trachea. And the trachea is a windpipe. Before that, epiglottis is a opening to the trachea, or it can even close when the food is getting transported. So it closes when the food is getting transported to avoid the food getting into the trachea and reaching the lungs and creating a total horrible disease, or you know, hiccups and sneezes and a lot of pain in the chest. So to continue with the trachea, then coming close to the lungs, gets separated into two parts, divides into two parts that are called bronchi. And each one of these parts are called bronchus, and these divide into the lungs. So we can show one of the lungs, and here in one of the lungs there will be other tubes called bronchioles, and these tubes go further and further, almost till, you know, 30 divisions, and then they finally reach tiny sacs, air sacs structures that, you know, hold the air. And that finally reaches at least two or three of these bundles of air sacs. There are at least 50 air sacs in one bundle. So here we have a small ball with which has so many air sacs. And if you see the cross section of it, we can see that around the each alveoli we have the bloodstream lines, and they pass through. And whenever the air, the oxygen comes in, that passes through the gaps of the alveoli and enters the bloodstream. So there's a small running blood vessel over there, and there are many red blood cells running over there. So they are actually not red in color. So the moment the air comes and reaches them, they become red in color. So there is a chemical exchange here. And from here, the process starts and it goes back to the bloodstream. And this we can continue. And the heart pumps again and again. And the heart sends the cells to the alveoli to get the air and come back. So this is the way this process happens. And by the way, the carbon dioxide that we are inhaling inside, because you see, whenever we inhale, there is 70% nitrogen and only 16 to 20% oxygen, and there is at least 0.04% or 1% carbon dioxide in the air we breathe. So now it is increasing, by the way, as we cut the trees down. So it is better to save trees. And when we run, we cannot breathe through the nose, because the mouth cavity is larger in size, so it can breathe in more and much more air than the nose cavity. So that's why when we run fast, we need a lot of air, and it's so fast that we cannot gulp in air as fast as the mouth with the nose. So that's why there's another minus point in the mouth also, because the mouth doesn't have hair-like structures called cilia that, you know, holds and captures the foreign particles and minute extra objects that are not necessary for the body and create and cause harm to the body. So it is always better when you are running, you can use the mouth, but it is always better to use the nose. So the nose has tiny hair strands called cilia, as I said, and these help in capturing the tiny particles, foreign particles, and these are taken out of the hair when we sneeze. So once in a while we sneeze, and this is not a thing to just go to the doctor and rush to the doctor immediately. This is just to expel those tiny foreign particles from the nose once in a while. So next, inhalation is the process where the air is taken in. Exhalation is the process when the air is removed out. And even in Ayurveda yoga, this is explained that pranayama is very good for the body. This inhalation and exhalation process, when done slow, is very healthy for the body, and the cells can immediately capture the air, and it will be very useful for the body, especially not in a city and crowded place like Bangalore, Delhi and Dubai. So it is better to sit in serene places such as with trees and you know, villages where there are many trees and not much pollution. So there we can do a nice pranayama, and this will be very healthy for our body. And next, there are tiny C-shaped structures to protect the trachea, the windpipe. Otherwise, it would have fallen down. So, as I said, this goes into the bloodstream, and I forgot about one thing, an important muscle sheet called diaphragm. Diaphragm is a muscle sheet that helps in it contracts when we breathe out, and it expands when we breathe in. So this is the work of the diaphragm, and it helps to increase the space for the lungs to increase its body size, and then it pushes up for the lungs to decrease, and this pushes the alveoles from inside, and then the air, carbon dioxide, gets out of the nose. So we cannot do so exactly like only the carbon dioxide would go out, but there will be a little oxygen too that is going out of our body. So, and this carbon dioxide our plants take, in. So that is a food for the plants, and they give out oxygen. So we always need plants, and it is better to keep indoor plants if we have any breathing disease. So it will be very good for us, and these generate oxygen for us to breathe, and they consume carbon dioxide. So next, going forward, this gets into the cells and the circulatory process continues, and this is how air helps for us. So next, we get energy by this. This gets into the bloodstream, and this these blood and other nutrition along with blood gets into other organs, and this helps. So the process of respiration starts from the nasal cavity, gets in, and it the foreign particles get stuck in the cilia. They go through the pharynx, then the larynx. Then the air goes through the trachea, then divides into the bronchi. Then from the one of the bronchus, it reaches into the left or right lung, and then it goes to the bronchioles. These bronchioles finally, after 20 or more divisions, reach the alveoli, and this reaches the bloodstream. So this is the process in brief. And inhaled air contains nitrogen 79% exactly, and oxygen is 21%, carbon dioxide 0.03%, water vapor varies, and exhaled air contains nitrogen 79%, the same, as we do not need nitrogen for our body, and oxygen will be 17%. So we take at least 4% in this process, and carbon dioxide will be 4%. So the inhaled would be 0.03, and carbon dioxide that is exhaled would be 4% with other toxins from our body, and water vapor will be saturated. So when air is inhaled, when air is exhaled, the diaphragm will move in, and when the air is inhaled, it moves down. So plants require carbon dioxide, or and they secrete oxygen-rich air. So next is the causes of respiratory diseases. So if you are working in a plastic factory or some polluted area, such as Bangalore, Delhi, and Dubai, which have a lot of traffic and pollution, and you cannot see the sky properly, as how it is beautiful blue sky with the sun shining. So this is not the way it would be in such smart cities. So it would be like the sky would be covered with dust and gray color clouds with a lot of pollution. So that's why if you're living in such a place, for sure you are going to get asthma, bronchitis, nose blockage, cold and cough, and there are viruses also. So too many, as now coronavirus has come, so that if too many people crowd together in a place, then we would get afflicted by such viruses and flu, etc. So next we can see the treatment for such viruses and other things. We know that it's not for coronavirus especially, because coronavirus cannot be treated by such small medicines.
What so it do you needs think about scientific 5G on the effect of the respiratory system? Is it dangerous?
So 5G is very dangerous for the respiratory system. When we breathe in, those frequencies destroy the body's organs one by one.
Yeah, so, they interrupt with yes. Oxygenation and deoxygenation.
Yeah, so the oxygen will be getting reduced in the air, and this will create a mass death of many people. So next would be treatment for respiratory diseases such as small diseases, asthma, nose blockage, cold and cough. So bryophyllum leaf tea. So there is a plant called bryophyllum. You can just check on Google. Type it on Google and you'll get the plant. I have also made a video on top of it, and you can watch that one. We can make a tea out of it by cutting the leaves into tiny pieces and putting it in some water along with some panakalkandu or palm sugar if you wish. Or you can drink it just like that, and never the sugar that you get from outside, the refined sugar. So next we can have nasya with medicated sesame oil. with, you know, club, pipali, emetic nut powder. So emetic nut would be Xeromphis spinosa is the biological name of it and botanical name of it. And pipali powder plus honey would be very good in empty stomach, such as 6:30 you can consume this before having your breakfast, and this should be very helpful. Next will be 40 to 60 decoction of onion juice. 40 to 60 ml decoction of milliliters decoction of onion juice, approximately half or quarter a glass. And you can just take the onions and grind them in the mixer, and you can consume them. This would be very good for nose problems.
These are amazing respiratory ideas for problems. Coronavirus too, isn't it, Abhidya?
Yeah, you can avoid the coronavirus with these remedies. So cloves plus flowers of madar would be good with black salt, kala namak. So this is a salt also produced from the sea, and we take it naturally, and you'll get rocks of it, and you can powder this and use at home daily, you know, with curd. So neem oil, some drops with betel leaves. So neem oil with betel leaves. So you can just boil some neem oil with some betel leaves, and this would be an essential oil to be put in the ear. And this would be very good for respiratory diseases such as cough and cold. And next we can also have mitti kati, licorice root, yashti madhu, ati maduram in Tamil, mitti kati in Hindi and Sindhi, yashti madhu in Sanskrit, licorice root is a common name in English. So this is the plant, and you have to take the bark of it, the root, the roots bark of it, and this will be very essential for our voice too. So our voice will also be in a very good quality. And next we can have bark of root of Calotropis procera with emetic nut powder. So this together would be a very good combination, powder of these two. This would be very good. And these are the treatments for respiratory diseases. We can also use it for asthma, bronchitis, bronchial asthma, nose blockage, cold and cough, along with high coughs. And we can treat everything with just a small tea that I'm going to tell you, with 16 ingredients. So you can watch my video on winter tea kashayam. And so I will just explain in a brief how to make the tea now. So pipali, you can add lavangam, elaichi, that is a small fragrance giving thing, and this is also very good for purgation, and it is very good if you are vomiting much. So this will stop much of vomiting, blood vomiting, and so many other diseases. So to continue with, we can add elaichi, lavanga, and pepper, piper longum, that is pipali, and also we can add tulsi leaves, basil leaves, holy basil, so osimum sanctum, and we can also add this bryophyllum, and along with that we can add the long pepper that I said, this short pepper too we can add, and yeah, these are the ingredients that we should add in a small tea along with ginger. So trikatu we can add, trifala powder, that is with the three ingredients. And we can make a powder of this at home, and we can utilize it for such a tea, and make a tea and give it to the patient. And this would be a cure and for even high coughs. Within 3 days, it can cure even high coughs. So these are the remedies and do's and don'ts. Please try avoiding staying in dusty atmospheres, polluted atmospheres, working for plastic factories, and please try taking measures to prevent such viruses, and have remedies such as this. And even if you don't have any virus or cold or cough and such flus, you can also take it as a preventing measure. So the remedies would be these: spreading hogweed roots plus sugar for bronchitis. It'd be very good. So Next would be powder of purple nausea, wild indigo. So this should be 1 teaspoon with honey, and this would be very good thrice a day. So these are the remedies, and this should be taken as a preventive measure, or even if you have. So you can consume it once in a week or so, and if you have such a disease, then you can consume it thrice a day. So this is all about respiration and the cures for respiratory diseases according to Ayurveda, our ancient old science of curing. And so thank you. Jai Shri Krishna, Jai Shri Ramachandra, Jai Shri Lakshmi Nrasimha.